Hi, I'm Antonio Mora. If it looks like you are overreacting, you're probably doing the right thing. Those words from top scientist and White House Coronavirus Task Force member Dr. Anthony Fauci are borne out by analysis of what's happened around the world this year with the COVID-19 outbreak, and by how the death rate of the Spanish flu pandemic varied between two American cities in 1918. Let's start with one basic fact. The spread of COVID-19 is exponential. It starts slowly and then explodes. In the simplest of terms, each person infected passes it along to 2.5 others. Those 2.5 infect more than 6 others, who then infect 16, who then infect 40, who then spread it to 100 people. You get the picture. You don't have to be a mathematician to understand that the sooner you slow down that exponential growth, the fewer people will get sick. Countries that act quickly to implement tough social distancing measures may be able to cut the number of deaths by 10 times or more. The sheer speed of transmission of COVID-19 in China overwhelmed health services. It jumped from one city to the whole country in a month. In the U.S., despite being forewarned, it showed up in all 50 states in well under 2 months. Take a look at this worldometer graphic on how the disease progressed in Italy. The growth in confirmed cases was stunning. From only 4 on February 20th, it jumped to 21, 79, and 157 on the next 3 days. A week later, it was more than 1,700. Less than 4 weeks later, the total exceeds 35,000. Here's where what people thought was overreacting can make a huge difference. Take a look at the historical example. Back in 1918, when Philadelphia's first cases of the Spanish flu were reported, authorities played them down and allowed public gatherings to continue, including a huge parade. Cases immediately spiked dramatically, as you can see from the solid line in the graph, and 12,000 people died in 6 weeks, overwhelming the city's health resources. Contrast that to St. Louis, which immediately took social distancing measures. Deaths there are represented by the dotted line. Fewer than 700 died, and the deaths were spread out over many months, a far lesser burden on medical personnel. Now, let's look at what happened in China's Hubei province, ground zero for the coronavirus outbreak. Wuhan, the capital, shut down on January 23rd when the city had fewer than 500 cases. Other cities started shutting down the next day. So take a look at this graphic. The lighter bars show how many people were diagnosed that day in all of Hubei province. The darker bars show the true daily coronavirus cases, determined after the fact by Chinese authorities by asking patients when their symptoms started. In other words, the lighter bars show you what authorities knew, the darker ones what was really happening. This is evidence of two highly important points. The official statistics dramatically undercounted the real number of cases, and true new cases started plunging almost immediately after the multi-city lockdown. An extensive, fascinating, and shocking analysis by Tomas Puello, published by Medium.com, he writes that when Wuhan thought it had 444 cases, it had 27 times more. So when you hear the official numbers from the government, you have to put it in this perspective. The official numbers are only the cases where people have been tested and diagnosed with the virus. The real cases are almost certainly far, far higher, likely 10 times the official number. That's the bad news. The good news for the U.S. is that the severe social distancing measures work. Wuhan shut down where there were only 500 official cases, and 2 months later, China has now had its first day without new cases. Singapore, Taiwan, and Hong Kong paid heed, did not wait, and they pretty much stopped the disease in its tracks with social distancing. Europe and Iran didn't learn the lesson, waited too long, and seemingly overnight they saw massive increases in COVID-19 cases. The U.S. response has been somewhere in between, although it's clear we waited longer than we should have to take the tough measures required. Every day that goes by where cities don't overreact is a wasted opportunity and means cases will multiply. Fauci says we are still weeks from knowing how effective the tough measures have been. But we can't wait and hope for medical treatments or for the summer heat to possibly limit the spread. Americans need a real sense of urgency, purpose, and discipline to defeat what may be the greatest challenge they have faced in generations.